Hama people. The Hama, also spelled Hama, are an Omotic community inhabiting southwestern Ethiopia. They live in Hama Warda, or district, a fertile part of the Omo River Valley, in the Debub Omo zone of the Southern Nations, Nationalities, and Peoples Region, SNNPR. They are largely pastoralists, so their culture places a high value on cattle. The 2003 national census reported 46,532 people in this ethnic group, of whom 10,000 were urban inhabitants. The vast majority, 99.13%, live in the SNNPR.1. According to the Ethiopian National Census of 1994, there were 42,838 Hama language speakers, and 42,448 self-identified Hama people, representing approximately 0.1% of the total Ethiopian population. 2. The Hama are known for the unique custom of bull jumping, which initiates a boy into manhood. First, female relatives dance and invite whipping from men who have recently been initiated. This shows their support of the initiate, and their scars give them a say on who they marry. The boy must run back and forth twice across the backs of a row of bulls or castrated steers, and is ridiculed if he fails. 3. The assistant administrator of Hama Bena, Ato Imnit Gashab, has commented that only 7 tribal members have ever completed secondary education. Harari people. The Harari people, Arabic, Harari, Riri, are an ethnic group inhabiting the Horn of Africa. Members traditionally reside in the walled city of Hara, situated in the Harari region of eastern Ethiopia. They speak Harari, a member of the Ethiopian Semitic language group within the Afroasiatic family. The Hala, an extinct Afroasiatic people native to Harag, are considered the precursors to the Harari people. 34. The ancestors of the Hararis moved across the Bab el Mandeb, entering the shores of North Somalia from Arabia, producing a Semitic population among Kushites and Hamites in what would become Hara. 56. Upon the arrival of the Arab Faji Abadir, the alleged patriarch of the Harari in the 10th century, he was met by the Hala, Gaturi and Argoba tribes. 7. By the 13th century, Hararis were among the administrators of the Afat Sultanate. 8. In the 14th century raids on the Harari town of Get Gay by Abyssinian Emperor Amdasian I, Hararis are referred to as Hala Arabs. 9. In the 16th century, walls built around the city of Hara during the reign of Emir Nur helped preserve Harari identity from being assimilated by the Oromo. 10. The 16th century saw the Emirate of Hara invading regions of Somalia, from the northern areas of Hargeisa to its southern portions, such as Lower Juba, incorporating the Harari people. 11. During the Abyssinian Adal War, some Harari militia settled in Gurij territory, forming the Silte ethnic group. 12. Hararis were furious when Muhammad Jassa decided to move the Adal Sultanate's capital from Hara to Osa in 1577. In less than a year after its relocation, Adal would collapse. 13. Harari Imams continued to have a presence in the southern Afar region in the Imamate of Osa until they were overthrown in the 18th century by the Madito dynasty, who later established the Sultanate of Osa. 14. Among the assimilated peoples were Arab Muslims that arrived during the start of the Islamic period, as well as Argoba and other migrants that were drawn to Hara's well-developed culture. 15. Statistics prevestation needed that a Semitic-speaking people akin to the Harari may have inhabited a stretch of land between the Karkar Mountains, the Middle Awash and the Jijiga. Oromo migrations have effectively split this putative ethno-linguistic bloc to the Lakes Way Islands, Gurij territory, and Hara. 16. Following the decline of the Adal Sultanate's ascendancy in the area, a large number of the Harari were in turn reportedly absorbed into the Oromo community. 15. In the Emirate of Hara period, the Hararai's relationship with the Oromo is somewhat complex. 17. The loss of the crucial Battle of Chilenco marked the end of Hara's independence in 1887. 18. Hararis supported the designated but uncrowned Emperor of Ethiopia Iyasu V. and his presumed efforts to make Hara the capital of an African Islamic empire. 19. Iyasu was however overthrown in 1916, and many of his Harari followers were jailed. 20. Due to severe violation of Harari rights during Abyssinian rule, Hararis made several attempts to cut ties with Ethiopia and unify Harag with Somalia, among them launching the Nationalist Club movement which was linked to the Somali Youth League. These events led to the Haile Selassie government's forced displacement efforts on Hararis, to break their control of Hara. 21. A Hara Oromo proverb alludes to this occasion. On that day Hararis were eliminated from earth. 22 former mayor of Hara Bereket Selassie reported that both the Amhara and Oromo viewed Hararis with contempt. 23 Haile Selassie's overthrow by the Derg communist regime made minor differences for the Harari. They describe it as little more than a transition from the frying pan into the fire. 24 The 1975 Rural Act disenfranchised Hararis from their farmland, forcing many to emigrate. 25 The surviving Harari relatives of Kalub movement members would join the Somali armed forces, and some, having been promoted as high-ranking military officers, fought in the Agadan War to free Harari, Somali territory from Ethiopian rule. 26 Hararis were also involved in the WSLF. 27 After Ethiopians won the war in Agadan, Derg soldiers began massacring civilians in Harari areas of Addis Ababa for collaborating with Somalis. 28 Today Hararis are outnumbered in their own state by the Amhara and Oromo people. The ruling Ethiopian government in power since 1991 has favored Hararis tremendously. They now control their Harari region again, and have been given special rights not offered to other groups in the region. 29 According to academic Sarah Vaughan, the Harari people's national regional state was created to overturn the historically bad relationship between Hara and the Ethiopian government. 30 According to the explorer Richard Francis Burton, Fiki Umar crossed over from the Arabian Peninsula to the Horn of Africa 10 generations prior to 1854, with his 6 sons, Umar the Greater, Umar the Lesser, the 2 Abdullahs, Ahmed and Siddiq. 31 According to Hararis, they also consist of 7 Hala subclans, Abon, Adish, Awari, Gadaya, Gaturi, Hargaya, and Warga. 32 The Harari were previously known as Adir, although this term is now considered derogatory. 33 Oromo and intermarriage took place between their ancestors and the previous inhabitants Adir, Harari, whom they call the Hadia. 3435 Hadia clans claim their forefathers were Harari, however they later became influenced by Sidama. 3637 Moreover Haba Habashid, a sub-clan of the Somali Isaac tribe in northern Somalia, hold the tradition they originate from an intermarriage between Hararis and their forefathers. 38 The Harari people speak the Harari language, an Ethiopic language referred to as Gay Ritma or Gay Sanaa, language of the city. It is closely related to the Eastern Gurage languages and similar to Zay and Silte, all of whom are linked to the Semiticized Hala language. 3940 Old Harari already had many Arabic loanwords, proven by the ancient texts. 41 The Zila songs of 13th century origin, popular in Somalia, are considered to be using Old Harari. 42 Northern Somali dialects use Harari loanwords. 43 Contemporary Harari language is influenced more by Oromo than Somali language, and the presence of Arabic is still there. 44 After the 19th century Egyptian conquest of Hara, numerous loanwords were additionally borrowed from Egyptian Arabic. Gafid language, now extinct, once spoken on the Blue Nile, was related to Harari dialect. 45 Harari language has some form of correlation with Swahili and Maghrebi Arabic. 46 The Harari language was historically written using the Arabic script and in characters known as Harari secret script, of unknown origin. 47 More recently in the 1990s, it has been transcribed with the Jerez script. Harari is also commonly written in Latin outside of Ethiopia. 48 The 1994 Ethiopian census indicates that there were 21,757 Harari speakers. About 20,000 of these individuals were concentrated outside Hara, in Ethiopia's capital Addis Ababa. 49. Most Harari people are bilingual in Amharic and Oromo, both of which are also Afro-Asiatic languages. According to the 1994 Ethiopian census, about 2,351 are monolingual, speaking only Harari. Virtually all Harari are Muslim. The earliest Kabir or Islamic teacher in the community was Orsofi Yahya, a Harari scholar who was contemporary of patron saint of Hara called Sheikh Abadir, and it was from him that the first Quran Gay Quranic school around 10 kilometers 6.2 miles to the south of the city center. 50. Notable Hararis. Abdullah al-Harari, leader of the al-Abash Sunni Sufi movement. Abd Allah II Ibn Ali, Abd Ash-Shakur, last emir of Hara. Nur ibn Mujahid, founder of Sultanate of Hara. Ali ibn Dar-Ud, founder of the Emirate of Hara. Bati del Wambara, queen of the Adil Sultanate. Abdullahi Sadiq, governor of Agadan. H. E. Samia Gutu, Ethiopian ambassador to Qatar. Col. Abdusalam Muhammad Faki, former military officer of Somali Armed Forces. CPT. Mohamed Ahmed Bomba, former CEO of Ethiopian Airlines. Dr. Duri Mohamed, former president of Addis Ababa University. Professor Ahmed Zakaria, Ethiopian historian. General Ali Gutu, former military general and Harare region president. Arab people. The Arab people Jerez, Irobi Arab, also spelled Arab, are an ethnic group who occupy a predominantly highland, mountainous area by the same name in northeastern Tigray region, Ethiopia. They speak the Saho language. Most of them profess the Catholic Christian religion and are mostly farmers. Point one. The etymology of the name Arab is debatable, but Arab's elders say that the term comes from the word Saho, Oroba, which means welcome to our home. The boundaries of Arablanda, to an extent, identical to the Arab border. Both are bordered by the following areas: Dabri Mela to the north, Hado to the east, the Afar region to the east and south, Shumzana and Gulomakeda to the west, and CCC Deyamba to the south. The first two neighbors are Saho speakers and predominantly Muslim, the third are Muslim Afars, and the others are Tigrigna-speaking Christians. The capital traditional center of Arab is Alatena. Arabs trace their lineage to one man, Sum, son of Negu's ward Meret, who according to the Arab oral history, migrated to the Arabland from Sirere in Kilitololo, a part of Tigray, about 700 years ago. Citation needed. Despite their relatively small population, the Arab have been at the forefront of regional and national politics in Ethiopia. Starting with the Zeman Mesafint, the Arab family of Shum Agame Woldu dominated Tigrayan politics. The dynasty included Djazmik Subagadis, whose rule extended to present-day Eritrea, Shum Agame Desta, Ras Sebat Aragawi, and many others including Emperor Yohannes IV. During the Italian invasion, Arab patriots, led by individuals such as Djazmik Ile Sebat and Djazmik Kasa Sebat, too contributed to the anti-Italian resistance movement from their base on Mount Isimba. In more recent times, many Arabs, such as Dr. Tsfe Debesse, who was a leader of the Ethiopian People's Revolutionary Party, EPRP, played an important role in the struggle waged against the dictatorial junta led by Colonel Mengistu Haile Mariam. Moreover, the Arabland proper, particularly around the Asimba and Iga localities, served as a base for several Ethiopian revolutionary movements, including EPRP and the Tigray People's Liberation Front, TPLF. Iga is also the location of significant battles during the Ethio-Eritrean Border War 1998-2000, which ultimately led to the removal of occupying Eritrean forces from the region. The Arab are divided into three major subgroup, Essora, houses Adgadia, Buknatia and Hezabala. The Adgadia and Hezabala are predominantly Orthodox Christians, while Buknatia consist of Catholics. The Arab economy is primarily based on agriculture, including animal husbandry. The region is also renowned for its excellent honey. In fact, the Mies Tej or local beer, honey wine, made from the honey is praised throughout the region for its quality. In general, the Arab are a bicultural community. With their Saho-speaking neighbors, they share a common language and certain social structures, such as a clan division system called Mela, and the title honor for their regional leaders. Many other cultural practices, including wedding ceremonies, dress, dance, and food, however, are more similar to their Tigrigna-speaking neighbors, especially with the peoples of Agame. Arabs also have distinctive customs. For example, they have an elaborate poetry-telling tradition called Adar. The Arab men have a danced step routine called Hora and Alkafo, which was traditionally performed in preparation for battles and still commonly displayed during weddings and other ceremonies. Kafako people. The Kafako people are an ethnic group hailing from Ethiopia. As of 2007, they accounted for only 1.2% of Ethiopia's population. 1. Most of the Kafako live in Ethiopia's Kafa zone, southern nations, nationalities and people's regional states region. The traditional language, Kafa or Kafanono, is still spoken among much of the population. 1. Coffee may derive its name from the Kafa zone, where it was first cultivated, though this is considered unlikely. 2. The Kingdom of Kaffa was established in 1390 and lasted until 1897, when it was fully integrated into the Ethiopian Empire, of which it had previously been an intermittent tributary. While the kingdom's economy had relied largely on the export of gold and slaves, the modern Kafako are agriculturalists. 2. Kambata people. Kambata, Kibata is the name of the people who speak the Kambata language. Their land is in south-central Ethiopia. It was a province of Ethiopia beginning in the early 15th century and ending in the mid-17th century. Ethiopian rule was once again established in the late 19th century under Emperor Menelik II. During this first period, Kambata province was largely Christianized. 1. The former province is contained within the contemporary Kambata-Tembaro zone of Ethiopia's SNNPR. According to the 2007 Ethiopian National Census, this ethnic group has 630,236 members, of whom 90.89% live in the southern nations, nationalities, and peoples region. Almost 1 in 5, 18.5%, live in urban areas. 2. The Kambata people speak the Kambata language, a Cushitic language. The Kambata kingdom was ruled by a long line of its own kings known as Woma, Wema. King Degoye, from Ayeta clan, was one of the famous kings known for expanding Kambata territories. The last independent king of Kambata was Wona Delbetau Degoye, who was killed while resisting Emperor Menelik II's invasion towards the end of 19th century. An important landmark for the Kambata people is Mount Hambaricho, where their king, Woma, used to live and the people used to celebrate annual festivities in the past. The king and the god of Kambata lived there. Clarification needed. They have many indigenous traditional foods, among which kocho kocho, which is processed from encete, is their staple diet. They also grow many kinds of tubers, spices, coffee, crops, and vegetables. Kambata society used to have stratified social classes such as Wumano Wemano and Kontoma Kwenitoma. Kwenitoma niyin yekabata hibi inidi ki behoni eni ni katenya theory yele yekwenitoma mahiberi sebi yemigenye begij zoni mezakani namariko werawachi lei in Kambata province. There are other clans like Tembaro, Alaba, and many more different clans live together and become Kambata. The most isolated clan in Kambata province is Tanas Shekla Sarawak, Fuga. This clan cannot participate in any socio-economic activities with Kambata. Kambata people can never marry Tanas, Fuga, clan. Kambata is one of the most densely populated regions in Ethiopia. The Kambata pride themselves as one of the best educated in the country. Due to overpopulation and lack economic opportunities in their region, they migrate to large cities, industrial areas and large plantation farms. In recent years they experienced large influx of migration to South Africa and Middle Eastern countries. Kwama people. The Kwama, also called Kwama and Komo, are a Nilo-Saharan-speaking community living in the Sudanese-Ethiopian borderland, mainly in the Mau-Komo special border of the Benishangul-Gumuz region in Ethiopia. They belong, culturally and linguistically, to the Koman groups, which include neighboring communities such as the Aduk, Koma, and Opuo. Although they traditionally occupied a larger territory, they have been forced to move to marginal, lowland areas by the Oromo from the 18th century onwards. In some villages Kwama, Oromo and Berta live together. The Kwama are often called Mau by other groups, especially by the Oromo. The people who live in the southern area and near the Sudanese borderland often call themselves Kwama, and use the term Kwama to refer to those living further to the south and in Sudan. These other Kwama are usually known by anthropologists as Koma or Komo, this 1995. In recent years, many people belonging to this ethnic group have been resettled by the Ethiopian state in order to provide them with clinics and schools. The Kwama are Swidden cultivators. Their staple food is sorghum, with which they make beer called shwi or shul depending on the dialect, and porridge piwash or fash. They also hunt mostly dika and warthog fish, and gather honey. They drink sorghum beer communally with drinking straws from a large pot. Marriage was traditionally by sister exchange, although this custom is now receding. The Kwama are divided into clans, some of which are also divided into sub-clans. It is not allowed to marry a woman or a man from one's own clan. Polygyny is widespread. They have ritual specialists and rainmakers, Sidmumun and Sidbish, who perform divination and healing ceremonies in huts called Swalshwamo. These often have a characteristic beehive shape, which is very typical of this ethnic group. For that reason, the Kwama refer to the traditional houses as Swal Kwama, Swal, meaning, house. Vinigi Grotinelli describes some of them in his study of the Mau, Grotinelli 1940. Konso people. According to Hallpike 1972, Konso family traditions indicate that they are a composite people, both physically and culturally, with members originally hailing from all the surrounding areas. 2. In terms of physical appearance, the Konso tend to be small and wiry, with high cheekbones and pointed chins. Skin color ranges from reddish brown to almost black, but is dark brown on average. Some individuals more closely resemble the Oromo, possessing thin lips and greater stature. Others have a distinctly more Afrikoid phenotype and are much shorter. According to Hallpike 1972, the latter somatic characteristics are more marked amongst Konso women. 3. George Murdoch 1959, attributes the pronounced Negroid influence on the Konso in general to early intermixture with the agricultural pre-Nilots, who entered the Ethiopian highlands about 5,000 years ago. 4. The Konso mainly reside in Ethiopia's southern nations, nationalities, and peoples region, south of Lake Chemo in the Sagan River Bend. 5. Many are concentrated in the Konso zone. Their territory is adjacent to Omotic, Sidama and Oromo communities. Konso typically live in large towns, each governed by a council of elders. A few can also be found in parts of northern Kenya. 5. The Konso speak the Konso language, also known as Afazonso, as a mother tongue. It belongs to the Cushitic branch of the Afroasiatic family. 5. Konso is divided into four dialects, Home, Duoro, Fasha and Karati. It shares a close lexical similarity with Dirasha, and is today transcribed using the Ethiopic script. 5. According to the 2007 Ethiopian National Census, the Konso numbered 250,430 individuals, of whom 10,470 or 4.18% are urban dwellers. Over 87% live in the southern nations, nationalities, and peoples region. 1. Although there are today marked differences in customs between the Konso and their Oromo neighbors, Konso society has also retained some commonalities with traditional Oromo culture. The latter include the Gadar generation grading system of social organization, similar high priests and a cult of phallicism. 2. Konso society is largely agricultural and involves the irrigation and terracing of mountain slopes. Staple crops include sorghum and corn, with cash crops including cotton and coffee. Cattle, sheep, and goats are raised for food and milk. 7. Polygyny is an accepted practice among the Konso. 7. Group members also erect carvings wagas, which are created in memory of a dead man who has killed an enemy or animal. The statues are often arranged in groups, with statues representing the man, his wives, and his adversaries present. 7. In terms of creed, the Konso practice a traditional religion centered on the worship of Wakwak. 8. In the related Oromo culture, Wak denotes the god of the early faith believed to have been adhered to by Cushitic groups. 9. Kor people. The Kor, also known as the Kort, are an ethnic group whose homeland lies in southern Ethiopia. According to the 2007 National Census, there are 156,983 members in this group, of whom 8.3% are urban inhabitants. 1. The Kor are found in the Amaro Special Warder, which is east of the Abia and Chemo Lakes. The vast majority of this ethnic group live there. Other members of this group live in the Burgi Special Warder and the Oromia region. The language of the Kor, Kort, belongs to East Omoto language subfamily with Kachama, Ganjul and Zais. It is the only Omoto language east of Lake Abia. The Kor are people of Enset culture. Enset, which is cultivated in all the three agroecological zones Diga, Wina Diga, and Kola, is the main staple food of Kor. Pea, wheat, barley, cabbage, lentil, bean, and onion in Diga. Maize, teff and sorghum in Wina Diga and Kola are largely grown for sale and for consumption. Livestock is also an important economic activity in Amaro. Coffee, chat, chili, lemon and bula, a fine byproduct of Enset, are the main cash crops in Amaro. Of course, Amaro coffee has the best quality comparable to the famous Yirgacheffe brand, and nowadays it is exported to over 50 countries of the world. Kor people are also known for the traditional irrigation system before 300 years. Though not as intensively as amongst the Konso people, terrace agriculture is also practiced. The Kor have emigrated from Gemo Highlands in the middle of the 14th century. Some informants also say a group of people emigrated, as Christian missionaries from Manse, Shewa, to Amaro, also called Korso by the Kor, via Dooro and Gemo between the middle of the 14th century and the beginning of the 15th century. 2. There were many dispersed and unified indigenous Oma clan in Korso when these emigrants came to Amaro. Korso. The new emigrants fought with these indigenous tribes and eventually forced some of them to fly to Burji, Konso and Darash. The remaining indigenous tribes were intermingled with the newcomers to form a people of new identity, the Kor. The emigrants who were assimilated with indigenous tribes were said to have carried with them Tabat, Ark of the Covenant, and are believed to have founded some Orthodox churches including Yero Medhane Alam, Ikagi or Gis, and Durba Menana Michael. Eventually the Kingdom of Amaro was established at about the end of the 14th century with 23 administrative units or districts called Dainit. Since its establishment the Kingdom of Amaro was ruled by Karts, Kings, Awoke, 1985. Oral informants say, Ahmed Gran, local called Lusa, invaded the Kingdom of Amaro, Corso, in the 16th century, thereby burning its churches and persecuting the Christians. Generally there were 19 kings from three dynasties in Corso from the middle of the 14th century to the incorporation of the kingdom into the Ethiopian Empire by Raslel Segud, general of Menelik II, in 1896. After its incorporation into the Ethiopian Empire, Amaro was organized as a warder, with its administrative center first at Qichele, then at Dano, and finally at Kiel, but before that it was organized into two sub-warders. This warder lasted until 1981 EC, when Amaro warder was partitioned between Gedeo and Gamo Gova. After the military regime of Derg was toppled in 1991 by the Ethiopian People's Revolutionary Democratic Front, Amaro was re-established as a special warder administration under the Southern Nations Nationalities and People's Region. Social organization. Kor has four tribal groups known as Goza, Kors, Kanare, Mana and Wogach. These groups or tribes are composed of more than 50 clans, Oma, some of which do not establish clear genealogical links to a common ancestor. The Kors and Kanare think of themselves as Shoro, pure, or clean, whereas the other two clans, Mana and Wogach, are despised, impure, or polluted. The former two tribes were cultivators who owned the agricultural land, whereas the latter two clans were, and still to some extent are, landless handicraftsmen. The Mana are potters and tanners and the Wogach are iron workers. The Mana and Wogach were not only landless, they also were and are marginalized and neglected. Because they were and are considered unclean, or polluted, they were are not allowed to eat or intermarry with the clean, or pure, Kors and Kanare. Still they do not intermarry with the clean, tribes and their burial sites are separate. Though these social stigma, discrimination and inequality is under challenge by the fast-spreading Christianity, especially evangelical Christianity, still it survives. Still there is no intermarriage between the Shoro and the artisan groups, even among the Christians. Pottery, tannery, and ironwork are still despised and are considered the business of unclean persons. Political structure. It had been mentioned above that Kor had a kingdom led by Karts, or kings. The kingdom is divided between 23 administrative units, Dainits. These 23 Dainits are accountable to two Awajos, the highest dignitaries under the Kart. Appointed district administrators, Dana, ran the actual daily administration and judiciary functions of the Dainits. Under each Dana were four offices, Usha, Maga, Tora Maga and Mura. Tora Maga was a war leader and Mura was a lower village chief or announcer of information and proclamation, Awoke, 1985. The two Awajos, called Yero Awajo and Aka Awajo, mostly had advisory functions though they had higher political and social status compared to the Dainas below them. Conflicts that arose between two districts or Dainits were solved by Awajos before they went to the court of the Kart. Karts have advisors called Bulatan. These advisors also consulted the Awajos and the Dainas. Besides these there were palace guards, traditional army called Sol, who were accountable only to the Kart. Karts were, are believed to be god anointed. Besides the political power, they were, are also believed to be rainmakers. However, they are not religious chiefs. Generally, though this traditional political system ceased to function properly after the Kingdom of Kor was incorporated into the Ethiopian Empire in 1896, it still has largely functional side by side with the modern administrative structure. Still the Kor honor their Kart as the traditional leader. Marriage. The Kor are polygamous and exogamous. As mentioned earlier, the Kors and Kanare marry to each other. This partly makes the Kor exogamous. On the other hand, however, some Kors clans also intermarry within the tribe or group and this disqualifies Kor exogamy. The reason for this seems that many clans in Kors do not establish a common genealogical descent. Except for a very few exceptions, the clans in Canaray claim common genealogy from a single father, Voijo, who is believed to be the founding father of the first core, Amaro Kingdom. However, as the tribal name Voijo is a widely spread generic tribal name in many Omotic people, a common ancestry claim of Canaray tribe group from Voijo is doubtful. Generally, core have five types of marriage arrangements: arranged marriage, abduction, bale, marriage by sudden appearance and obligation of a girl's family, levirate marriage, and mishira, secondary marriage, usually practiced by widows or divorced couples. Generally, omen interpretation is very important in marriage arrangement as well as other social life. In the recent past, the dowry price paid for a girl's family in core society was only symbolic and had the purpose of strengthening a filial relationship. Currently, however, the amount of dowry payment is becoming extraordinarily high to become a serious social problem. Virginity has a high social value in core society. If a girl is not a virgin, she will be considered an adulteress and is beaten by her husband. The community does not give the girl due respect and her families are also humiliated. Birth, status of children and gender. A core prefers to have a son to a female. When a female bears a child, people who come to visit her first ask her what sex she bore. Her answer is symbolic. She says, "I have yele," meaning a human being, or mum, meaning a solid, if she bore a son. On the other hand, if she bore a female, she says, "I have a gats," meaning a traveler, or kana, meaning a dog, or zelo, meaning a wooden bowl. A son stays at his father and ancestor's place, hence, solid, at his ancestral land. A female marries and goes to permanently live with her husband's family, hence, a gats traveler, or kana, dog, that roams from place to place. Religion. The supreme god of Kor is called Wanto. Wanto is the creator of earth, the water, the sun, the stars, human beings, etc., and the whole universe. As Simon, 2002, says, the term Wanto has connotative meaning, day or light. Thus, day and light symbolizes the identity of God, Wanto, for the core. However, as Wanto is far away from people, ancestral spirits, Adi, Akko, possession spirits, Chus, and Laha, soothsayer, are believed to be mediators between Wanto and human beings. Due to this, family, clan or regional heads make many forms of sacrificial rituals for ancestral spirits and possession spirits. On the other hand, as mentioned earlier, Christianity has a long history in Amaro. The first Ethiopian Orthodox churches, established during the 14th century, were Yeromedhane Alam Monastery and Ika Georgis and Derba Michael churches. As core oral tradition says, Christian immigrants who were believed to have come from Mens through Kaffa, Dawaro and Gamo to Amaro were responsible to establish these churches. However, during the wars of Ahmed Grand, the churches were burned and the Christians were persecuted recklessly. The remaining few Christians and priests were forced to flee to Berbir Mariam in Gamo, and other places. It is said that after this historical incident, the core people relapsed to their old traditional religion and remained so until the Ethiopian Empire builders reintroduced Christianity in the 19th century. This time, however, Christianity could not spread rapidly and could not have many followers because the reintroduction of Christianity was related with subjugation of the northern feudal empire builders. Thus, the Orthodox influence remained minimal until the evangelical Christianity was introduced to Amaro in the 1950s. Currently, most of the core are followers of different Protestant sects. Generally, there are complex situations regarding Christianity, either Orthodox or evangelical, in core society today. As Simon, 2002, says, the people regarded Orthodox Christianity as foreign Amhara religion that was added by the dominant Amhara to be worshipped. Though Orthodox Christianity itself is highly synchronized with traditional religion, it insisted that putting aside all their traditional practices was a prerequisite to become a Christian. Due to this, every part of core culture is seen as useless and demonic. On the other hand, though evangelical Christianity is currently dominant and widely spread, its disregard for core culture and its deculturation of core is being felt negatively. Simon continues, the evangelicals, on the other hand, are completely negative to core culture and they reject every part of core culture as demonic. In other words, to evangelical churches, becoming Christian means abandoning their culture. This ends with deculturation. Death rituals. Life from birth to death and life after death is a continuous process for Core. For the Core, death does not mean the end of life. Rather, a deceased person continues to exist in the realm of the unseen world as ancestor. The spirit of the deceased ancestor could be a nice ancestor concerned for his living lineage, or it could be a bad spirit called Sahays, Gomats or Moitile that could inflict danger on its living relatives. Because of this belief, the Core have successive death rituals to appease the dead person. The death rite starts with burial ceremony. The first ritual after burial is called Aisha Gels, meaning, bringing back the spirit of the dead person, and starts 40 days after burial of the deceased person. Up to 40 days the spirit of the deceased person is believed to roam around his ex-living home and garden. The spirit of the dead is highly feared in these days. For the ritual of Aisha Gels, the eldest son of the deceased person, the head of the clan of the deceased person and a tenki or soothsayer, take fresh milk and flour of different grains and go to the grave of the deceased person. The tenki, who is believed to have a divine power to communicate with the spirit of the deceased person, sprinkles the milk and the food on the grave. The spirit of the deceased person is believed to come towards the tenki to take the food and the milk. At this moment the tenki grabs the spirit and takes it back to his ex-home. This is followed by another ritual called Limoepa, necromancy, in the ex-house of the deceased person. Many people gather into the ex-house of the deceased person to attend this ritual. The tenki who brought the spirit back to his ex-house begins to talk with the spirit, Limo, and translates what the Limo says to the gathered people. This ritual can last from few days to weeks as far as there is enough food to feed the gathered people. Generally, the purpose of these rituals is to know the case of the person's death. On the other hand, a died person is believed to live in the world of truth, that is with Wanto, God. So the gathered people consult the spirit about the well-being of his family and the society as a whole in the future. They also consult him what actions to take in order to avoid drought, epidemic disease, natural catastrophe, etc. After the ritual of Limo concluded, the living relatives of the deceased person occasionally offer sacrifices of milk, wheat flour mixed with Enset Bular or livestock to the ancestral spirits. As mentioned above, Yero Medhain Alam Monastery is an important historical and religious site related to Core origin and identity. Besides these, Walo Sabala, Walo Hot Spring Kati Sabala or King's Spring, a natural hot spring in Nekazar National Park are considered sacred forest sites. Sites such as Yero Walla, Sagan Shash, Gumarush and Gudina are sacred historic as well as religious. In addition, there is Mount Dello and its natural forest, Guna Bido, a standing pole of King Guna, and Gomail, the sacred burial site of Core kings, especially kings of Inkalo dynasty, are important sacred historic relics of Core. Many sacred ancestral clan cemeteries, Busa, and naturally revered forests, such as Wankuro Wara, Shefo Wara and Gani Wara are also important historic as well as cultural relics.